tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, Alan Carr, Sarah Pasco, Ron Allen, Rosie Jones, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jim.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, the show that combines the breezy humour of Countdown with the academic rigour of 8 out of 10 Cats. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's team captain Sean Locke. When Sean took part in Let's Play Darts for Comic Relief, he called himself the midwife, not because he always delivers, but because on this show, he says he's always surrounded by a massive bunch of... Well, let's leave that there. And joining Sean tonight is Sarah Pasco! Sarah has published a book about the female body. I read the pop-up edition. Unusual book. It was me that did the popping up. Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Alan Carr. Alan Carr, he's what it would look like if God had said, I like humans, but what would it look like if I replaced their teeth with some broken custard creams?
Who's tapping that? Don't!
And Alan's teammate, Tom Allen. I'm trying not to mention the shape of Tom's head this evening, but it's really difficult. You end up walking on eggshells, damn it. Tom's career has really taken off recently. He's hosting Bake Off, The Professionals. He's been on Channel 4's Comedy Gala. In fact, the only thing that could stop him now is if he sat on a wall and had a great fall.
Leave it, Tom. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. Leave it, Tom. Leave it! Leave it!
Alan, I hear you've had a new addition to the family.
Yeah. I rescued a dog from Korea. It was going to be eaten in a meat festival, and I
rescued it. The dogs are like a delicacy there, aren't
they? Yeah, but the dog's ever so small. I mean, you'd have to have, like, a side of fries or something with it. I mean, it's tiny. It's like a hairy vol-au-vent. But, yeah.
You rescued a starter.
Yeah. But, do you know the weirdest thing ever?
Go on.
I came in the room the other day and it was sitting in the chair like a human watching Pointless.
I think we have a picture
of this.
Have you got a picture? Yeah, we've got a picture of this.
Look at that! And I'm thinking, is that a dog? Or are we just like... Because if that's like a man in a suit, that's kidnapped. That's not Rehoboam.
It's smuggling, isn't it?
It's smuggling, yeah!
OK, Sarah, what is your greatest fear?
Probably weddings. Ooh. I hate weddings. Look, I understand the thing about, like, loving someone forever. Like, that's lovely. But the rest of it, come on. I had to go to 5 weddings last year. All of them had hashtags. the worst one, they sang their vows. I was watching, thinking, this is what happiness looks like. I'm glad I'm depressed. And it wasn't, like, funky singing. It wasn't, like, all cool, like in a film. It was incredibly earnest. I do take... You, Ian. I hate Ian. Caroline. I shouldn't have used their real names. I fear weddings. I think they're awful. I think if you want attention, just become a stand-up comedian like everybody else.
I kicked over a baby once at a wedding.
Congratulations! That sounds like a good wedding.
That was a good... No, have you ever been like in a really fast conga and can't get off? I was congering, like, yeah. And this baby came out and I'm like, move!
Okay, Tom.
What?
Tom, do you think you and Alan will make a good team?
Well, finally, I think we're going to bring some masculinity to this goddamn sissy show. Yeah. For too long, I've seen you and you mincing around here.
Yeah, we're sick of you pussies.
We're here to bring a bit of blokiness to the whole experience.
Yeah.
People are fed up with you talking all the time and being all Nelly about everything with your quiff.
Yeah.
I've been very Nelly in the past. Yeah.
You've been banged to rights, Sean. Banged to rights.
Banged to rights is the sort of thing we're going to start saying in our masculine way.
Okay, Sean, have you got a mascot?
Yes. A lot of people say to me, Sean, your life seems so smooth, so effortless. You never seem to have any problems. How do you do it? And I said, it's because I've got loads of life hacks, you know. I've come up with a book of my life hacks, just ways to make your life easier. There we go. OK, Sean's life hacks. Instead of eating a sandwich, just put it straight in the bin. And later, you won't need to go to the toilet. Time saved. On your suitcase, when you're going on holiday, write Ghoulies in white paint, so you know it's your bag. Extend the life of your courgettes, right? By keeping them in a condom.
See, I saw that earlier, I thought it was Alan's.
Don't wave that in my face. Move it. Stop it.
No handy tips like that, Jimmy. I've got loads of them. Instead of making a cup of tea, make a gallon, drink a cup, and freeze the rest. Then, use it when you just fancy a cup of tea. Put it in a saucepan, and half an hour later, you've got a lovely cup of tea. And also, you can do this with coffee and bath water. And I'll do one more. Save money on fireworks by rubbing your eyes.
Sean likes life hacks, everyone. Brilliant. Sarah, have you got a mascot?
Yes.
What have you got?
One of the things I find really difficult on the show is the letters and the maths. And but I think the reason I'm finding them difficult is the concentration. I get distracted. Oh, look, there's Sean Locke. Oh, look, there's Rachel. So I thought, who's really good at concentrating? Horses. And so I've got myself blinkers like a horse. So that when we're doing the rounds, I won't even look at Sean. I won't look at Rachel. I'll just do my work like this, like a horse on the high street. Like, it doesn't know you're there.
It's a great idea. It looks a little bit like a jockey is teabagging you, but I love it.
Does it? Where's the... No, it doesn't. I've got an orifice up there. I've got a blowhole, Jimmy.
OK, Tom, have you got a mascot?
Well, actually, yes, I do, Jimmy. I've decided to bring along as my mascot, it's a gay rugby team. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Wessex Wyverns. This is the Wessex Wyverns gay rugby team. This is Daniel. He likes cross-stitch. This is Nick. He had an argument recently with his uncle about blue passports. And this is James. He likes playing rugby and he likes playing older men off of one another. I've always wanted to be their mascot, so I thought, what could be better than if I asked them along as my mascot tonight?
Why do you want to be their mascot?
Because my type is officially men who are chunky and kind. And I need to feel safe, and also because I am very, very lonely.
Have you met Tom before?
We've never heard of him before.
How lonely.
As a rugby team, have you got a mascot at the moment?
Oh, we do. My niece.
Yeah, well, she's actually not as good as she thinks she is, and she needs to watch herself, because that job's got my name written all over it. So all of you can shut up and get off the stage, actually. Go on.
Can I have my courgette
back,
sorry,
please? Sorry.
There's a reason I put them in here. Not a toy.
Alan, have you got a mascot?
Yes, I have.
what is that? What well, listen, is it?
Well, I've had a blockage. It's a fatberg. I had to have Dynarod round, so this is all the stuff they found stuck down my sewer. I mean, there's a Blue Planet DVD. Look at the irony of that. Sweet corn there. I mean, I know it goes through you, but it's still in the can there. I mean, and also, because I... Oh, this is where it is. Bloody hell. Oh. Oh, it's celebrity tipping point. No, I'm out. There's actually a photo there, a signed photo of Cliff Richard. I wish I'd waited for the court case to carry on, but I panicked and just tried to get rid of it.
Alan Stadberg, everyone!
My Stadberg! Oh, disgusting.
Well, over in Gentry Corner, it's Rosie Jones! Now, Rosie, it's your first time on Countdown. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Oh, well, hello. I'm Rosie, and I am a character comedian. Some of you are laughing, and some of you are going... Is she? Is she pretending to be disabled? Yeah. it's just a bit of fun.
Rosie Jones, everyone. And with Rosie Jones, it is, of course, Susie Dent. Yeah. Susie Dent has promised to send me a copy of every single one of her books, and I hope they arrive soon, because tomorrow is bin day. Susie, have you been researching anything new recently?
I'm looking at body language a bit, really? Which is really interesting. And, you know, there's the obvious things about, like, defensive and looking down your shy and all that stuff. But these, like, really micro gestures that tell you, that send you a message. Women turning their back on you, Jimmy, for example. I genuinely found this out. I had no idea about this. Apparently, there's a 3-second rule that if you gaze at somebody, hold someone's gaze more than 3 seconds, it means either kiss or kill.
Well, let's try this.
All right.
Both. Yeah.
Try to decide the order. That's fascinating, body language.
Have I just said something you found fascinating?
Yeah, genuinely fascinating.
Stop right there.
All right, quit while you're ahead.
I'm happy with that.
Excellent. I love that. Okay, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel, you're starring in a new sci-fi film, I assume.
Yeah, well, you're Empress of the Fairies.
I just looked over and saw Alan and Tom both going like this and then...
No, we were saying we love it.
You liar.
Gorgeous. I did it. You're lying. You love what Rachel's wearing.
You said it's like bejazzled a doily.
No,
you're such a bitch, Tom.
Oh, I love the masculinity you're bringing.
Damn, damn, I told
you. We nearly had it, Alan. We nearly had them fooled.
Now, Rachel, you're a Manchester United supporter. Do you ever get any stick from other supporters?
Well, the United fans are always a lot nicer. I was spotted on a tube going to a cup final once by United fans, and they started singing a song about me and just made up on the spot. It was, Rachel Riley is a red, is a red, is a red. Rachel Riley is a red, she hates Carol.
OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Bagpipes. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Alan and Tom, you get to pick the first lot of letters. Ooh.
I'll have, what should we have, 4 consonants?
Sure, I don't mind, yeah.
Yes, please.
S-D-N-P.
Can you move a bit of that thing on your shoulder. Thank you. It's like the beginning of a migraine, that twinkling in your...
Are they wings? Have you got it on backwards?
No, it's just like... I mean, it's kind of like one of those lizards.
Was it for this?
It's a velociraptor. Do it again.
A gay one. A gay one.
Like a velociraptor about to go out to a cocktail party.
I'll have some... how many vowels?
Three?
Three vowels, please.
Oh. I don't mind them.
You two sound like you're ordering in a restaurant.
You three.
You've got to try their consonants here. They're delicious. Absolutely delicious.
A consonant to share, please.
Half those vowels.
And just another consonant, I'm driving.
Hang on a second.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock. Sorry, Susie, I was messing about with her.
Yeah, thanks.
No. Now we both forgot brain damage.
Why are there two men under your seat?
They're always there.
What are we doing with that doll? Alan, how many?
Six.
Ooh. Tom, how many?
Seven.
You haven't.
Pluralized, didn't I? Yeah. Wow, yeah, I like a plural being.
Sean, how many?
Seven.
Sarah?
Six.
Six, okay. What is your six, Sarah?
Loused, like when you get rid of lice. L-O-U-S-E-D.
Oh, great. Yeah.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Or loused
up. I've never thought of that.
It's because you've got no hair.
Alan, you're six?
Mopeds.
Sean, you're seven?
Modules.
Nice.
Ooh.
Lovely.
Listen to that.
Lovely.
I mean, you talk about easily impressed, this crowd.
Yeah.
They're like the Wimbledon crowd, aren't they?
Yeah. Tom, what's your seven?
Well, I went one better than Sean, and I went for nodules.
Ooh. Ooh. Susie, Rosie, could they have done any better? What do you think, Rosie?
Your sevens slumped.
And spumoni.
What, sorry?
Spumoni, you know, that really fancy dessert with lots of layers on it.
Say, I didn't read it out, could I? Thought it said spum one.
Spum one. Spum one to love. Spun one to hold.
Very good.
Okay, so at the end of that, both teams have 7 points. Whoa. Okay, on to our first numbers round. Sean, Sarah, you got the first pick of the numbers.
Get my tea bags on.
Can I have two from the top and the rest from the littles, please? The little ones.
Spoken like an expert.
Thank you.
Yeah. Four little. Six.
Just watch and learn.
Four, seven, 10. Big one's 175.
So the target was 903. Alan, did you get it?
No, nowhere near.
How close did you get?
All I heard was la la la. I go into blind panic. It's like when you hear like an ambulance and you're driving along. And
you panic.
You panic.
Tom, did you do any better? Did you get it?
940 I got.
Well, I could get nearer than that.
What did you get?
Well, look, I mean, mean, you could just do that.
What did
That's
you get
closer
then?
Than that.
But what did you get then, Alan?
Well, I can't add it up.
Sean, did you get it?
Yeah.
Sean, you got it? And Sarah, I presume you got it because you were all focused. You were in the zone then.
The thing is, I know you're being sarcastic, but it's the closest I've ever got. I got 901. This is working as a system. It's a science.
OK, Sean, how did you do it?
10 times 100.
10 times 100, 1,000.
Minus 75.
925.
OK, 4 times 7 is 28. Take that away, then add the 6.
Perfect, well done.
I mean, 10 points to Sean.
Very good.
Thank you.
The scores, Alan and Tom are on 7, Sean and Sarah are on 17. And here is your teaser. The words are red moves. The clue is where the magic happens. That's red moves, where the magic happens. See you after the break. The words were red moves. The clue was where the magic happens. It was, of course, bedrooms. So, Sean and Sarah are in the lead. Sean, have you got any more of those life hacks make life a bit easier for the rest of us?
Yeah, I do.
There's a bit of luck in it.
Yeah, here we go. OK, just another one. Shoplift from charity shops. They didn't pay for the stuff, so whose is it anyway? The security in charity shops is usually just an old woman in a tabard. Avoid the pain of a tattoo by rolling around on wet newspaper. That's Rita Ora. She's dancing, look. There's more. Save money on herbal tea. Drop a Glade plug-in into a mug of hot water. Hey, just finish an apple. What are you going to do with the core? You're going to throw it away, aren't you?
Of course I am.
No, you're not.
Oh.
You're going to make a lovely decoration. Look at that. Don't you think they really make Christmas? They're lovely, aren't they?
Sean's life hacks. OK, they've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Alan and Sarah. So, Sarah, your turn to choose.
Yeah?
Total focus.
Do you want to put your tiny Christmas tree away, or are we keeping that for...
Oh, yeah, sorry, was that distracting you?
Those blinkers are a bit shit. How did you see that?
The trouble is, horses love apples, so actually it was very distracting.
Well, you've really got into character for this.
It was the role I was born to play. Vowel, please.
A.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
C.
Vowel.
O.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
Why?
Why? Oh, yeah, I guess it is, isn't it? It's tricksy, because you feel like it's a vowel. Consonant. Another consonant, please.
And S.
OK, your time starts now.
All right, lads, it's time to ride. We are going to sweat in 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Let's get up some speed. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. What's this? Jimmy, where are you going? Jimmy! Come back, Jimmy!
Feeling the burn. Is he knackered? Sarah, how many?
7.
7? Alan, how many?
I've got a risky 6.
A risky 6. OK, what's your 6?
Moisty.
Moisty.
Ooh. Oh, is it me or is it a bit moisty in here? Yeah.
This cake's a bit moisty.
Yeah. Mm, moisty. Is it a thing, moisty?
Yes, moisty is there, unfortunately. Well, lovely for Alan, but a horrible word. It means of weather, moist or damp.
Oh, yeah? I love
that word. It says archaic, but what
the hell? I was convinced you made it up.
No.
Sorry, Mike, what are
you doing?
Huh?
So are you doing...
I've got to turn this fucking thing round. Get rid of it somehow.
What's are you actually in control of it, Jimmy?
I'm in some control, but not much. It's got no
You've
reverse.
You've never looked more like a cartoon.
Sarah, what's your word?
You'll be proud of me, Jimmy. This is such a countdown word. I've got the word mascots.
Yes.
Mascots.
Yes. Damp. Oh,
mascots. 7 points for your team, Sarah. Rosie, Susie, could they have done any better?
Mystics.
Mystics?
Mystics and miscast as well.
OK, so at the end of that, Alan and Tom have 7, Sean and Sarah have 24 points. Right, now time for Sean and Tom to go head-to-head. Tom, your turn to pick the numbers.
Can I have 6 numbers, please, Rachel?
Yes. 75, 10, 8, 4... 7 and 25.
Mmm, now you're talking.
And the target, just for you, 666.
Oh, God. OK, your time starts now. So the target was 666, the number of the beast.
Mmm. Oh, no, I'm a beast, I am. Oh, all the girls say it.
You're more Vin Unleaded than Vin Diesel. Can I just say that?
OK, 666, did you get it?
668.
668, pretty close. Sean, how'd you do?
665.
Ah, he's on fire.
OK, how did you get 665?
I got 665, Jimmy, by using all those numbers. I did. 8 times 75 is 600.
8, 75, 600.
7 minus 4 is 3.
Yeah.
Times 25 is 75. Add that on and take away the 10.
Yep. Well done, Wombley.
Well done.
7 points for Sean. Rachel, could it be done, 666?
It could. If you say 75 plus 7 is 82, times by 8 is 656, add on the 10 for the sign of the beast.
Oh.
Oh, there we go.
Time now to go across the dictionary corner. Rosie Jones, what have you got for us?
Well, I think people look at me and they go, oh, bless her. She's got all that poultry. Don't feel sorry for me. Being disabled is amazing. And to show you this, I'm going to talk you through the great reasons to be disabled. Right. Number one, you can dribble. On people. Oh, I can't help it. I can. Number two, you can get free shit. When I go into cafes, people look at me and go, oh, do you want some free shit? And I get free coffee, I get free cake, I get sex. And number three, this is a secret. Nobody knows that I'm a dick. Everyone just thinks I'm a cute little disabled lady. It's incredible. Stylish magazine voted me the most remarkable woman of the year. Thank you. Thank you. I'm not the most remarkable thing I've done this year is I want for 8 hours.
Rosie Jones, everyone. The scores at the moment, Alan and Tom have 7 points, Sean and Sarah have 31 points. Ooh. And here is your teaser. The words are orgy huts. The clue is it's only natural. That's orgy huts. It's only natural. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were orgy huts. The clue was it's only natural. It was, of course, yogurts. Now, before we go on, he doesn't work here anymore, but he keeps on turning up anyway. It's Joe Wilkinson.
Yay! Yay!
You're right, Joe. What have you been up to, mate?
Well, because you fired me because you're a prick. I've gone back to being an inventor, so I've started inventing again. Made myself a few quid. This is actually one of my inventions. It's actually a baby papoose for adults. Only downside is you need a giant who's prepared to carry you around for the afternoon. This one's mine. It's Glenn. George Toffee, Glenn. Yeah, hold on. He loves toffees. Here you go. So, I've got a few other inventions I could show you I've been working on. Come on, Fabio. You remember my half-brother, Fabio? It's another one of my inventions. It's a lovely little idea, this is. Don't know why it's not been done before. It's actually a mobile toilet seat dispenser. I get Fabio to walk around the town with this, and if anyone needs a new toilet seat, he just dispenses one. Go on, mate, show him how it works. Really simple, lovely little idea. Sits. Really nice little feature, that. Don't wave, you fucking idiot. Also got another little idea where this looks like a normal chip and pin machine, doesn't it? But we've actually customised one, made it into a lovely gravy boat. But my best idea... Well, bring it on. Bring it on. Well, should we just wander over? You know when you've put a bit of weight on when the UK's strongest man is struggling to... Yeah. So, right, this is my it's my best design, my best adventure. Do you like it, Jimmy?
What is it?
What do you mean, what is it, you fucking idiot? It's, actually, Fabio, do you want to show him? Start her up. Oh, I've just remembered there's an on switch. There we go. There we go.
Ooh.
What do you think of it now, Jimmy?
Well, I mean, it certainly looks impressive. What does it actually do?
It's a bottle opener.
Alan, Tom, your turn to choose the letters.
Oh, Joe, what's that?
I've got some felt tips. This has been such a long evening. I'm not listening to this shit. I'm going to do a drawing.
Vowel? You have a vowel?
Yeah, a vowel. A couple of vowels.
Couple of vowels.
E and U.
Oh, contentious. Oh, don't get me started. Oh, that's enough. We've had enough. Everybody's had enough about it. Let's go home. Come on.
Couple of consonants, please, love.
Yeah.
Oh. S.
I think a couple more vowels.
Couple more vowels, please.
I.
A. Couple of consonants, please. Now look. Oh, those G. awful shoulder pads. I can't see anything. Yeah, and then a vowel, please, love.
E.
OK, and your time starts now. Sarah, how many?
Five.
Five. Sean, how many?
Three.
Three?
It's quite hard. Too many vowels, I think.
They were really badly chosen letters, weren't they?
They were appallingly chosen letters because they don't take it seriously.
We do, but we're so caught up in our masculine pursuits.
Yeah. Give us a couple of examples.
Guttering, that sort of thing. Blokes love guttering, don't they?
Well,
every November, I'd better get up there, clear out the gutters. I ain't gonna pay somebody to come round here, clean out my gutters for me, I'll do it. Give me the ladder, Daphne.
OK, how many?
Three.
Three.
I've got six.
Six? OK,
yes.
So what is your three?
Sag.
What's Sag. The point?
What's the point?
Sean, your three.
Doug.
Doug. Sarah?
I've got five, if anyone's interested.
I've got five as well, Joe.
Is it the same? Say it at the same time.
One,
Ikea's.
Two, three, Dukes.
Oh, I can't count, yeah.
What have you got, Sarah?
Dukes. D-U-K-E-S. Like
Dukes.
The plural of Duke.
Alan, what have you got?
Another made-up word.
No, it's not another made-up word. Is guides a made-up word?
Oh! Were you in the guides?
No, I wasn't. I was in the... no, not worth it. Now, in Northampton, we had beavers. Do you remember bees?
Yeah.
I was a beaver.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you got the tea.
Yeah, on the
tea. 6 points to Alan.
Yay!
Rosie, Susie, could they have done any better?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Seven Gordies.
Gordies.
Gordies, you know those sort of reunion dinners at colleges.
Oh. Anyone want to see my picture of an egg?
Yes.
Yeah.
Not very good, Joe.
All right. Do you want to see the other thing I drew?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Back of my own head.
Wow. That's good.
That's good.
Yeah, shut you up.
OK, the scores at the moment. Alan and Tom have 13. Sean and Sarah have 31 points. OK, time to go across to Victory Corner once again. Rosie Jones, what have you got for us?
Well, I got some more great things about being disabled. Number one, you can dial it up. And when I can't be bothered going to work, they lit up a rainbow box and they go, oh no, the palsy flared up again. Straight down to the pub. Day off! You can also dial it up when the disability inspector comes around. So hopefully they're not watching this. And number two. You don't have to deal with any kids. It's amazing. None of my friends will leave me with a kid. Because I do drop them. And then I recruit them. It's like a pyramid scheme.
Rosie Jones, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are splat goo. The clue is stop whacking it. That's splat goo, stop whacking it. See you after the break. The answer to the tease. The words were splat goo. The clue was stop whacking it. It was, of course, goalpost. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean, Sarah, your turn to choose.
I'll help.
Oh, thanks, Joe.
Do you want to draw something?
Sure.
You ready, Joe?
No? Yes? Sorry, Sean, you're scaring me.
Ready? Vowel consonant, vowel consonant, vowel, vowel, vowel consonant.
Fine. Vowel consonant. Vowel consonant.
Sorry, consonant, consonant, vowel.
Consonant, consonant, vowel. Consonant.
No.
Vowel.
Ow.
Consonant.
No,
there you go.
No, no, I wanted a consonant, not a vowel at the end. Please. Thank you.
Stick that G up there. Okay, your time starts now. Freezing in here. How many?
I've got six.
Sean?
Six.
Sarah?
Six.
Six, six, six again. Really, how are you doing this, Rachel? Tom, what
six,
you get?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm embarrassed. Anus.
Anus.
A legitimate word. It is a word.
Alan?
Romans.
Romans.
Oh, that's a good
that's
one.
That's a good one.
I'm just going to keep anus up, if that's all right with everyone.
Yeah. Sean?
Organs.
Organs.
Oh, no, I'm still going to keep one. Anus.
Sarah?
My one's the same letters as Sean's, but rearranged. I put groans.
Keeping anus.
We're going to keep anus up, though, because we know what our fan base likes. Yeah. OK, 6 points to both teams. Rosie, Susie, could they have done any better?
We want another cheeky six orgasm.
OK, so Alan and Tom have 19, Sean and Sarah have 37. OK, fingers on buzzers, it's time for today's Countdown Conundrum. Your time starts now. Let's have a look and see. Wow. Yeah! So the final scores are Alan and Tom have 29, Sean and Sarah have 37. So Sean, Sarah, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Bagpipes. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching. That, and that's it from us. Good night.
Dream team, Sandy, Noel, Paul and Prue. It's like Totally Jammy and it's back. The Great British Bake Off returns Tuesday at 8. And on the same night, 11 celebs who are a bit scaredy about water are going to take on the English Channel for Stand Up To Cancer. Grease up and jump in at 9:30. But next tonight, late-ish with Mo.